Right, finally a new trip. We are so excited to be out and about. Again, it's been a couple months since we've been filming, and a big change on this trip. Two new cast members, two new characters. Ty Heaps, who is a Marine, and Zach Collins, who is a 38-year-old teddy bear.
I got to know Ty on a spring bear hunt that went wrong, terribly wrong. But that's for another time.
Clay asked me to come on and fill the spot on Expedition Overland. And obviously, right off the bat, it was a huge honor. And the second question that came to my head was, why me? You know, I haven't done a whole lot of overlanding before.
Probably about 2 weeks ago, Clay gave me a call and asked me if I wanted to go on one of his trips. And I had been kind of keeping up with the episodes as they were coming out and thought it was going to be a lot of fun, but didn't quite understand the magnitude of what happens on these trips.
I have known Zach and his identical twin Groovis for a long time. We both share a love for fly fishing. However, I would classify his love as obsession.
Ryan Erickson has never met any of these guys.
There he is!
How's it going? Nice to meet you, Zach. You guys are very nice to meet you, sir.
Nice to see you, brother.
Having a good day?
Yeah, really good day.
Before long, we noticed that Ryan wasn't on his usual ride. A blown wheel bearing forced his hand to borrow his wife's 650.
That's why your wife has a bike.
Yeah, don't tell her that.
We set off into the dark, an hour's drive into northern Wyoming. Upon arrival, the environment was angry. Ryan Erickson seemed to sleep great that night, but everyone else didn't.
All right, morning one. Yeah, morning one. Yesterday didn't really end.
Is there sausage in this one?
I think so.
Let's try this again.
Yesterday didn't really end because I went to bed last night and never went to sleep. Yeah, the weather, I don't know. This is, you just never know what you're gonna get. I see blue sky over there. It might work out okay. But we got this intense Jeep trail to do this morning. We're not even sure that the Land Cruiser can make it up around the tight switchbacks. Ryan's not even sure he can do it on the bike. So, and it's his wife's bike to boot.
We were all out of sorts, stumbling around like zombies. Ryan and Ty one-upped each other with boot camp horror stories.
Didn't even have a flat top on it.
While Zach meticulously folded down the rooftop tents. All the while, Scott stumbled out to film nature. I listened to the weather as if it mattered, and then decided to have a useless meeting.
I think the Land Cruiser and the trailer should go in the middle and have the truck in the rear. That way we have the ability to winch forward and the ability to winch back.
How long do you think it'll take us?
4 or 5 hours, 6 hours.
To get up the
switchback?
Yeah, probably 6 hours.
Switchbacks?
See, now I get up on top.
Oh, it's good.
Yeah, go team.
Let's do this.
Yeah!
Despite our carefree attitude, we knew it would be tough, and we didn't really know how long it would take. The Morrison Jeep Trail has been in place since the late 1800s. Chief Joseph himself and his band came out of Yellowstone through this canyon. This is a land formed from fire and ice. Glaciers cut the deep canyons and eventually left behind their entombed boulders dropped on the shale riverbeds. Yeah, 8:30 a.m., 28 switchbacks to go.
You ever done anything like this?
Nothing like this.
Not like this.
X2, this is X1. You guys ready?
Let's do this.
Let's roll.
Here we go, guys.
Volcanic shale proved troublesome, just feet into the mountainside.
This stuff is so loose.
I don't know.
With your bike right here, I'll be sliding down this way.
You need to get your bike up first. Bike.
Where's the snatch spot?
Stopped in our tracks. It was time to go to work.
We need to reach that.
Can you come back another 2 inches, 4 inches? You get this rock out? You want this rock out of here?
Yeah, you can.
So I've got a question. Do we need to pull it further? Yeah.
That's doable.
Yeah.
There we go. X2, this is X1. We just heard from Ryan. He says you're going to want to take this one as wide as possible. How copy?
Copy that, Lima Charlie.
This one's your light tire, so you get a track in there.
You can't get this trailer around the end right here, so it's gonna hit the rocks. It's just way too steep. I don't think anybody's ever been in here with a trailer. So I think what we're gonna have to do, what we're doing now, is we're gonna hook a strap up right here, and then snatch and go right back to the trailer, right to the back end, and then just winch the trailer uphill and help it take the corner. So I think if we do that, I think we can do it safe enough.
Sometimes you blow an O-ring.
Progress was now measured in inches.
Feet. Okay. Keep going, go, go, go. There you go.
The summer day had reached its peak at 95 degrees, and the heat was taking its toll. The switchbacks were seemingly endless, and we worked tirelessly through the day. Every turn, a new challenge. We were committed to the top.
Yeah! I worked out!
As far as this edge here, right, the clay, and then jackknife it over here, I think we can go right up.
Okay. How's it looking back there for that back corner?
Whoa, whoa. That's officially the farthest. Oh, look at that thing.
That's pretty rad. Yeah. About a half inch from a tail light right there.
Soon the sun gave way to the shadows of the mountain, but the problems became more intense.
Keep coming, keep coming.
I can't hear you, man. You want to put one more in there?
You got it.
Yeah, come on! Come on!
Stop.
It'll go, it'll go.
You good?
Up, 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 up! Yes!
No way!
Yes! Okay, hold on!
Hold up! Stop, stop!
3 more hours till the top.
This is a type. Right here makes the call.
He won't make the turn. Not yet.
Yep, you're gonna. Yep, yep. Oh. And you got that foot.
So crank it the other way.
Thanks.
You're a long way from trouble.
Yeah, let me, I'll snap a photo here real quick. Go ahead and back up.
The Land Cruiser crippled to its knees. We were forced to winch.
So, let's take the tree saver and we're gonna thread it around the backside here, thread it through this gap, and have it come out the bottom.
This thing or this
tree? Yeah, this guy. So, find the center.
What thread?
Yeah. There's about the center. Is that about the center? Yeah, that'll be perfect. Okay. So, we want that point to be really equalized. So, yeah. Yep.
Like that, kinda?
Yeah. Yep. Perfect. Yeah, this is just right. The angle's just right. It'll be enough to get him out. I think that's about it. Kind of feels like a mountaineering right now.
I think we're gonna have to hold that until there's tension.
Yep. Yeah, until there's tension. A little precarious, but the angle should be fine.
Because it'll tighten up on that thing.
It'll tighten up and it's gonna wanna pull this rock this way.
This is a good enough rock.
Yeah, so we'll just have to really watch it. That'll be your job.
Done.
Just look for the gravel falling out of here and stuff, and then as soon as it's, we just need to get him
out
2 feet.
Yep, he's good.
Yeah, yeah. You see, I had to walk away and get some zen time. Get a little zen going.
Just got a little...
You're like, center.
Before I left, as I was talking to Groovus, and he's like, dude, you're going to have so much fun, blah, blah, blah. And he's like, there's 2 people I trust with my life, and Clay Croft is one of them.
Dude, this is intense.
This is intense. Okay.
zero.
Just make sure that's way in there.
Okay, go ahead and tension.
Thank you very much.
Are you good? Okay, drive up a few feet. Awesome.
I think I might want to snuggle with Jeff.
Yeah. Jeff's been in the hot seat.
So I like to define the word pucker. I think our good friend Hefe in the lead driver's seat just defined the word pucker. I was puckering for him. Clay was puckering for him. But look at him, he's a happy boy now. Good job, Hefe.
I love you.
I need a hug.
Seeing that tree shake is pretty much the last thing you ever want to see. And oftentimes is the last thing you ever see before you die.
The sun captured by the horizon, the final stretch had been reached.
I'm gonna do those switchbacks.
What? Switchback. No.
At least we have something decent to look at tonight.
Dude, you rocked that thing, brother.
That was awesome.
We got a good night's sleep, finally. And I don't think it could have been pouring rain, thundering lightning, everything. I think every last one of us would have slept after the day we just had. We didn't know, we knew there was a few more switchbacks, but we didn't know what they were gonna be like. If it was gonna be like yesterday, or if they were gonna be just doable and we could just run right up it.
Could have some weather coming in.
We were bogged again.
I think all we need to do is just hook him up with the snatch rope.
Yep.
We got the locker in on that one. We'll use the longest one because we're probably going to spit some rocks.
Yeah.
But he just needs a little help.
They'll give him a hump out of the hill.
Yeah. It should be good.
Just to kind of help each other climb.
This isn't rodeo. This is the smoothest, most consistent pulling we can put together.
We're just going to try to back up out of our ruts a little bit, maybe take it down there and line on it.
Roger.
Come on, the Land Cruiser's got to go at the same time. So we just both hit at the same time and the line comes taut and you just hope that he pulls out of that rut. If you make a wrong move up here, you're a long ways from help.
After a few initial attempts, the approach worked.
A lot of spots where the Land Cruiser would have got stuck, but we pulled right through it because we have that tow line on there.
Awesome.
A major rain could easily cause the road to become impassable.
Because if that hits us, we're screwed.
Yeah. Yeah. Look at that weather coming in. That's 20 minutes from now.
Ryan, could you hit that?
We had to hurry.
License plate.
Thunder thighs.
I guess we're not at the tip top.
A little more to go. Well, I don't know. This might dive off. I think it dives off, and then we just kind of run along the ridge a bit here.
Okay.
So I think we've made it. I think we're totally made it.
At the top, we entered the Hobbiton Forest. Zach encouraged us that if we had any troubles with Hobbitons, that two to the chest, one to the head would take care of any problems encountered.
Okay, transform.
Hey, XL1, what's our elevation getting to?
9,530.
9,530. What's this trail top out at, you think?
I'd guess 9,000.
We would guess
540.
The afternoon storms cleared. The view was nothing short of expectations. Several hours of trail remained before we rolled off the trail, aired up, and headed into Cook City to regather our bearings.
Road. So we'll just kind of take whatever the main route is through here. And then, we'll turn off there, and we're probably going to stop at Round Lake or one of these other lakes here. This is it. This is it. Because you can see there's no trees.
Well, there's a meadow, right?
You can see the meadow. Right, and see there. This road goes through the meadow. Goes through the meadow.
Then those don't hook up, do they?
No. And this road cuts into the trees.
The trail was rough. Rocky rough. Like cobblestone street rough. And further up the trail, Ryan had discovered a small issue.
Just heard a swear word come out of Ryan Erickson. That's the first time I've ever heard a swear word come out of Ryan Erickson.
Oh no. Our worst fears are realized.
Do you have any JB Weld?
Yes.
You do?
I think I do.
Hopefully we can repair it. Hopefully it doesn't get parked here.
Until tomorrow.
Okay, well, at least get it.
I don't think it's very bad, because I definitely have no lights came on or anything.
While we're here, I think we should, before we go any further, we should crawl into the rigs and just do kind of a quick look over everything.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and you're aware of that light that came on, right?
Yeah, I'll get out the computer and check that out. Okay.
I'm guessing it's a 420 code, which is a catalytic converter, bank one and bank two. It usually pops on when we're at low idle and the computer senses lower, below normal threshold tolerances in the exhaust. It's exactly what kind of thought it was, the PO420 code. Catalytic converter system, efficiency below threshold, bank one. And second code is the same one, so bank two. So, no big deal. Erase codes.
And it got moved.
And I don't know if we got moved at the shop or we got...
And then wipe it off. So, definitely got a cracked oil pan. So far this trip, I've broken the mirror on the wife's bike, broken the license plate mount off on my wife's bike, broken most of the skid plate mounts off, and now I cracked her oil pan.
You probably broke a mirror.
This is...
You're sleeping on the couch for a while, buddy.
A long time. She is probably going to kill me if I'm lucky. Definitely got some splaining. So do you think what my wife would forgive me by the time the episode airs? Because she's not really going to know about this.
How you plan on hiding this one from her?
Got oil pressure, should be good to go.
All right,
see you up the trail, Scotty.
Yeah.
Our equipment back together, camp was the next objective.
He's gonna buck off. Game over.
What happened, Clay?
It's Coach Master
just
Clay.
Just put me back in the car. Just put me back.
I don't want to talk
that.
About it.
I don't want to do that again.
Camp was squirrely. Ty tried fly fishing, seemingly for the first time. And Ryan had an incident with the lantern.
We're here to reclaim the pizza fiasco that we had in episode one.
Yeah. It's like a bear took a big turd in there.
It looks like a pile of turd.
A rocky start, but not bad.
Oh man, beautiful!
That's your turnout.
Boom. Just like my grandmother used to make.
The rest of the night we talked, laughed, and relaxed.
Except my girls don't like their daddy very well.
Again that night we slept great and woke to the sounds of nature. Until Ryan got up.
I found that my bash plate was bent badly enough, and because I'm extremely irresponsible, I don't check things like broken bushings and gone bolts, and it moved the bash plate into a position where it itself was hitting the oil pan. And it did it again after I repaired it and cracked it worse. So now I have to try to repair the worst crack. Try her again.
The coffee was out and gone cold, so Ryan and I went to find gold.
We gotta find traps where there would be...
Right there.
Yeah, let's go try over there.
Yeah.
And the dense stuff will go to the bottom. No, it's too light.
Back at the lake, Zach was casting 40-foot perfection. Soon we all join in for a fly fishing bath. but the weather didn't hold.
Ah, first two cracks of lightning and thunder. So, putting on some shells, because cameramen are guaranteed to get caught in it at some point.
It was time to get moving.
And the quick steel holds. As you can see, we have had zero leaks after about 12 hours. So this has my personal money back guarantee that it might work.
One last task: to devour the Beartooth Highway, one of the top motorcycle roads in America. This trip was a wild success, one of my personal bests of all time.
It's just been a major learning experience. We challenged ourselves and we got through it.
The new guys fit in like a glove, and Ryan had been baptized and redeemed with asphalt awesomeness. Amelia, you are true. Adventure really is worthwhile within itself.